previously on this gravity series. We exposed humanity's 2,000-year-old affair with gravity, how gravity is and isn't force, and out of nowhere, this phase, this equation, where does it even come from?
Weren't we talking about general relativity, which looks like this? Well, this equation is actually a child of Einstein's general relativity. And that's just one out of the so many equations we use to make our lives easier. Ever wonder how these equations came into existence?
So fundamentally, we come up with equations by looking at relationships between variables. For example, say I'm trying to relate height with the time it takes for something to reach the ground. See that at these intervals, the object is in these positions. Plot them in a graph so we can see the relationship clearly and we get a polynomial function.
But how do you get an equation from something you can't exactly see? Things like the curvature of space-time. First things first, what was Einstein doing with gravity anyways?
So at the time, Newton's was the only theory of gravity. One problem. Newton didn't really explain the mechanism as to how gravity worked. Another was that his theory had to be adjusted to explain the time lag for gravitational effects from the sun to be felt in places like the Earth. Because before 1905, we thought if the sun exploded or something, we'd feel its effects at the same time. But Einstein's light travels at a fixed rate rule meant that light from the explosion would have to take about 8 minutes to reach us.
Einstein was one of the people working on an updated theory of gravity, and he noticed something from the other new theories that the other scientists didn't really consider much of an issue. When you increase the horizontal velocity of an object, the vertical displacements aren't exactly the same, when they should be.
So what happened? He noticed this object thrown with a horizontal velocity had more kinetic energy than something you let fall. Einstein kept this in mind and would later include this in his theory of gravity.
It wasn't just matter that mattered, it was also energy, and this is expected because about 10 years before, he published a paper equating matter and energy.
And while on the topic of falling objects, he levels up a bit. You know, what about falling people? Now, a person in free fall would not feel their weight, as if the gravitational field just disappears. This led Einstein to wonder about the difference between gravitational mass and inertial mass. Gravitational mass dictates how much gravitational force we feel. Inertial mass dictates how much we would accelerate when acted on by any force. In Newton's theory, these were equated to each other.
Einstein wanted to know why this is something you can just assume. There should be an explanation.
So he came up with the equivalence principle. See, people used to think that in free fall, the gravitational field just disappears.
But Einstein had a different interpretation. It's not that it disappears, it's that gravity is the same as acceleration.
I talked about this in depth in my last video, so check that out if you haven't.
Now wait, where did the idea of curving space-time come from?
Well, we don't have to look too far. With the equivalence principle, Einstein thought of the pathway of light when the box is being accelerated. And it would look like this.
Weird, since we know light travels in straight lines.
The only way to explain this is if space-time was that thing that caused the bending. And since gravity is the same as acceleration, we would observe this bending in gravitational fields. All he needed was an eclipse to prove that, and he did get one. And he got crazy famous because of it.
Okay, so what made him think space-time is something you can curve in the first place?
See, this was around the same time scientists were experimenting on whether there was this thing called the aether that permeated through all of space-time. The Michelson-Morley experiment didn't detect any of that wind. Supposedly, with the aether, light changes speed. And with Maxwell's equation saying the speed of light is constant,
Einstein thought of a simpler solution. We didn't need an aether, we just needed space.
With all of this, it seemed clear that he needed an equation that related matter and energy with curvature. It took him 10 years to finalize this equation. The earliest version was generalizing space-time by including gravitational phenomena in the form of curved space-time.
And let me tell you, Einstein had help. He didn't come up with this himself. In fact, the 1913 version of this paper had two parts. The first was Einstein's physics, and the second half was Marcel Grossmann's math.
But this wasn't the final form. If the conditions were a weak gravitational field like our sun, where Newton's theory worked with enough accuracy, this draft of Einstein and Grossman's didn't return the same results. Einstein then reviewed his work and came up with 10 more equations to fix this.
Imagine proposing this to replace Newton's single equation. Yeah, it wasn't going to happen. It then took him 2 more years to realize what went wrong, and although the reasons are still being debated, one is that he thought curved spacetime wasn't needed for weak gravitational fields.
Thinking places like the sun have flat spacetime. His theory then couldn't even explain the weird motion of Mercury. But by November 4 of 1915, he kept sending out corrections to his own theory.
A week later, for the first time, he published the very equation we use today. So that answers the title of this video then. I think I can finally sleep now. Except, not really. I kind of have more questions, and one of them is this. What now if we can quantify the curvature of space-time? That shall be answered in my next video. In the meantime, check out my gravity playlist because I may have answered some questions you got from this video in my other videos. If you want to know how from nothing we ended up knowing so much about gravity, watch this. If you're wondering whether or not gravity were a force, I've got the perfect video for you. And if you're tired of hearing the word gravity, check out my channel for some other science topics. Thanks for watching, I'll see you next time.